Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and please remain standing in the wish to bow your head for our legislative chair. Legislator Kabut, would you like to make this please? Legislator Anastasio, can you say the prayer please?
We gather to make decisions for our community. May we use only our best skills and judgment, keeping ourselves impartial and neutral as we consider the merits and pitfalls of each matter that is placed before us. And always act in accordance with what is best for our community and our fellow citizens. Amen.
Roll call please.
District 1, Legislative Sitchmiller.
Present.
District 2, Legislative Woodman.
Present.
District 3, Legislative Adelizio.
Present.
District 5, Legislative Alabama.
Present.
District 6, Legislative Martin.
Present.
District 7, Legislative Castellano.
Present.
District 8, Legislative Woodman.
Present.
District 9, Legislative Sullivan.
Present.
District 4, Chairwoman Serena.
Present. Moving on to approval of minutes. Approval for the regular meeting, July 5th. Public hearing, July 5th, and public hearing, July 11th. Item number 5. Correspondence from Howard County Auditor. Erroneous taxes, we have two refunds. Both from the town of Carmel School District, one in the refund amount of $11,470.66. The other, realizing $4,204.56. Realizing fiscal impact of $894.82 and $328.56 respectively. Resolutions moving on to our Economic Development and Energy Committee. I call upon Commissioner Anastasio.
Thank you, Chairwoman Serena. On behalf of legislators, Commissioner Sullivan. 6A, approval designation, Putnam County Business Bureau, Tourist Promotion Agency. Be it resolved that the Putnam County Legislature hereby designates Putnam County Business Bureau as the Tourist Promotion Agency of the County of Putnam, and further authorizes the Putnam County Business Bureau to make application for and receive grants for the purpose specified in the New York State Tourism Promotion Act.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Moving on to 6B is the approval of Putnam County Tourist Promotion Agency, I Love New York Matching Funds Program.
Are you ready to make a motion to accept the additional payment to 6B?
Yes. You're introducing Putnam County's maximum entitlement of state matching money. It must propose a tourism commitment in the amount at least equal to the state award. Be it resolved that the County of Putnam will provide to its tourist promotion agency funds equal to the actual state award for the I Love New York Matching Funds program for the year 2018.
Okay, would you like to repeat the revised section for 6B?
Well, this revised, I did read it in that way. All right, in the amount that would happen. Okay, not to exceed was stretched out.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Moving on to our Physical Services Committee, by Thomas K. Alano.
Thank you, Chairman Massarino. On behalf of Legislators Castellano and Johnson. Legislators Castellano, Scutamara. Myself. I'd like to move 6C, approval of budgetary transfer 17837 to County Executive for preliminary engineering and loop work, creation of two sewer districts. This is on the east and west ends of the county, and also the investigation of
community that creates the sewer district. I spoke to some of the business owners last week in Manhattan, and they were concerned about the cost of this to the taxpayers, and they wanted to know the details, of which I didn't have any. And also, this is a $16 million project, according to the CFA application that was approved last month at the legislature. I think that we should be going after New York City. I don't think they're paying their fair share, because we're in a watershed area. I mean, there's no more capacity in terms of sewer. So I can't imagine us taking on this behemoth project, and again, without any sort of business plan or explanation to the club of how we'd be able to make this money back to justify $16 million. And in the past, yes, the estimates have always been inaccurate, so it's not. So for those reasons, I think we'll be going to see that.
I agree, New York City should be paying more than a fair share. The interesting thing is we have two areas that we identified that have potential for growth. The beauty here, unlike in the past, is that we have two sewer treatment plants that could take on this capacity. They're already built and they exist. They operate well and they work in that capacity or close. So having that opportunity without having to build a sewer plant, I think it makes a lot of sense to at least investigate to see the feasibility of a project like this. It could light up our corridors, it could bring in tremendous amounts of sales tax, it has tremendous potential. As far as the cost of this kind of a project, when you bond these things over many years, it becomes very cost effective. The benefits way outweigh what the cost is. So again, at the very least, we should spend some time and explore it, because these sewer plants do exist and they have the capacity, so I'm very much in favor of this.
Chair. Yes, thank you.
I'll be voting in favor of this because this is an opportunity for our county to open up those corridors, as Legislator O'Donnell said. The reason that the county is involved is because these plants are in, are outside of the county. Right? So that's why this is not, the towns can't create a district, can't build these new sewer plants. When you look at $16 million, and until we have a feasibility study, we can't give that to you. We don't know what the numbers are. But we had a sewer plant upgrade about 20 years ago in the Hamlet farm. That was a $30 million upgrade. It was a $30 million cost. It was bonded over a lengthy period of time, low interest rates. This is an opportunity that we should not say no to.
And I was going to mention the fact that both of these sewer plants, one is in Selma, which is Westchester, and the other one is in Danbury, Connecticut. And I was told that the sewer district that ran, that runs from Capitol Avenue, the town of Cornwall, to Kmart, which is Route 6, costs $1,800 per property without the usage costs. This project, which will run from Calvin to the Westchester border in Merrimack, off of Route 6. It is supposed to go to Somers, to Heritage Hills, and I understand the cost of that. It's very, very expensive because of the distance, as well as the Danbury plant, that there would have to be substations because of the distance and the logistics of it. And again, Danbury would be charging us, you know, whatever they want to charge us, whatever the going rate is. So we're putting us in, I think, at a disadvantage. But having said that, again, I wish that a lot of business or property owners along the states would realize what's happening here, because I don't believe they know that if this thing goes forward, they're going to be paying for it. And so, thank you.
Team projects like these are important. They're not going to get cheaper as time goes on. They're only going to be more costly. And we have to start thinking of the future. Septic fields and overpopulation is killing us environmentally. So I think this is something we have to look at. And we are, that's exactly what we're doing with this 160. We need a feasibility study to look at all the information we can get.
Thank you.
I'd just like to add that I do speak to commercial property owners. I myself am one, and I happen to be in a school district, and I find it very beneficial. That, of course, there's an increased tax and there's expenses to it, but it far outweighs the negativity. It just works so well for commercial property. Like I said, at the very least, we should really investigate this as infeasibility. Those plans exist, they have capacity. And until we know answers, if we'll numbers out and say it's not feasible or economically it doesn't make sense, we're just taking guesses. And pump stations are part of all sewer systems, so none of them fall completely down the hill without a problem. That's part of the design of the system.
Thank you, Chairwoman. I also agree with the comments of Legislator Albano. I, for one, actually have a business in one of the areas on Route 6, so we're talking about putting the sewer. I've spoken to a lot of my neighbors there and people in the Chamber of Commerce, which I'm a member of, the man back, and they're all very positive about the possibility of getting a sewer in there. For many different reasons, you know, the ability to expand their businesses and their buildings, the environmental, the positive environmental impacts it could have with, with the lake and its proximity to the septic tanks. And I just think at this point, it's just a feasibility study to look at. We haven't voted on doing anything yet other than maybe a look and exploring the topic. Everybody that I've talked to, and my business is right along this area, is in favor of it. I haven't heard anybody that's anything bad about it. You know, the cost, we will see what the cost are when we get to that point and make that decision.
Yeah, I just want to reiterate that. We've got to remember what stage we're at. We're looking at a feasibility study for this. This could be a great opportunity for Putnam County. And we need to look at all aspects. One of the things we discussed last month was the fact that if a property owner wanted to opt out of the system, they can do so. It's not going to affect that. But we need to start somewhere, and a feasibility study is where we need to start. It could be a public situation.
That's not quite accurate. The pipe runs in front of your property, you have to pay a capital charge.
That's not true.
No, that's not true. Maybe we're calling it.
But once we have a feasibility study, we're getting all those questions. We need to take that step.
Yes. And before any of this moves forward, if a majority of the property owners within those districts petition, they can petition for a referendum among those property owners affected. So there are a lot of circuit breakers that can be in place. Also, I just read that the Palmer County Board seems to be in favor of at least the feasibility study. That's what we're talking about. We're talking about just exploring. I think it's unwise that to just say no to the exploration.
I'll be voting in favor. I believe it's very important, especially in our local model. We would definitely need a positive environmental impact. We have failing septics that are affecting the lake and the Palmer. So I will not vote in favor.
And we just brought that up. I know there were failing septics in some of the condo complexes too. Some of these things are difficult to fix if not impossible. So sewers are a definite positive option for those particular issues.
This is just a feasibility study, and we have to really consider the infrastructure throughout the county. And to do that, we have to spend money to make our community put it into the 21st century, and we're going to need to do that. And all this needs is to go for a feasibility study.
No, I just wanted to finish up by saying I read the CFA agreement. So one of the requirements in order for us to move up the ladder in terms of the grant application for us to possibly be picked or awarded the money, you have to invest money in the project to sort of show that you're serious. So, and to that point, I just want to say that I'm glad that the town of Parma favors it. They should be paying $160,000 then, instead of the county.
Okay, I think we heard this segment, so just not to be here and not to be redundant. utilize and maximize what we can here in Putnam County for our future from both a economic and environmental standpoint. Again, as we mentioned numerous times, this only gives us the opportunity to see if this is at all feasible. So we just speculated here with the cost and what we're going to do and how we're going to do it. That all remains to be seen. So this just provides the opportunity to open the door, and that's what we're voting on here this evening. So, I'd like to call for a roll call, please.
Legislator Evanzio.
Yes.
Legislator Albano.
Yes.
Legislator Castellano.
Yes.
Legislator Goldman.
Yes.
Legislator Young.
Yes.
Legislator Lewis.
No.
Legislator Scutamaro.
Yes.
Legislator Sullivan.
Yes.
Chairwoman Messer.
Yes.
Motion carries.
Thank you. 6D, approval of 2017 consolidated bid funding application, CFA, for grant funding for projects aimed at increasing local economy development and encourage growth in Putnam County through capital infrastructure projects. In particular, items that were identified as Manitoba Station Road, which has been in front of us a few times for issues, and then possible railway connections to Tilly Falls and Farm.
Any discussion? All in favor?
6E. Support the Putnam County Veterans Residents Lease Agreement of Renewals. This is standard lease renewals in July. No changes for veterans.
Any discussion? All in favor? Capital Fund, Legislator Sullivan. Chairman of the Rules and Acts and Intergovernmental Relations Committee.
Thank you, Chairwoman. On behalf of myself and legislators Evanzio and Albano, I'd like to talk about item 6F, the approval budgetary amendment for the county clerk and the local government records management improvement fund grant award. The county clerk has requested a budgetary amendment to account for the local government records management improvement fund grant award in the amount of $147,725. The grant is a shared services grant in conjunction with the Town of Carmel and will add to the existing electronic document management system created under the provisions of 2016 and 2017 grant and addresses the problems that are prevalent with the storing and access of paper records. This grant will run from July 1st, 2017 through June 30, 2018, and there are no matching county funds required, and therefore no approval resolution was needed to apply for said grant. And whereas the Rules of Enactments and Intergovernmental Relations Committee and the Audit and Administrative Committee have reviewed and approved said budgetary amendment, now therefore be that the following budgetary amendment be made.
Any discussion?
This is good with the Town of Carmel, so it's another example of working together to accomplish this great idea.
Absolutely. And also, at the same time, reducing the waste of paper and resources, so it is great, great thing. Do we have comments?
Yeah. The Town of Phillips Town has been working on this also. We approved that, I think, six or nine months ago. And it's quite an undertaking to do this. They're digging up files that haven't seen the light of day in 20 or 30 years. But it's a great way to clear the decks.
But also, I think it's a great job for the town clerk's office to take on this mission. I for one am going to tell you that, you know, doing electronic filing for everything just makes us so much more efficient. It's just minutes, seconds away, you pull up on the computer screen on the report of the bottom of our house. It's just a win-win, and it's a great thing to do.
All in favor?
Aye.
Moving on to the Technical Services Committee, call upon the Commissioner.
Thank you, Chairwoman Nasserino. On behalf of the members of the Technical Services Committee, as I said, it's Castellano and Yonke. I make a motion to move the following items. Item number 6G, approval of approve fund transfer 17P131 by replacement ERT, which emergency response team uniforms, which for a cost of $35,000.
Any discussion? Just want to note that legislative group had requested a breakdown of what the uniforms really entail, and we did receive a list from boots to jackets, and the total command is $1,508.28. So it is possible to purchase these uniforms.
But we were told that these, the oldest clothing, will last for some time. This is more of the stuff, and we've got a couple sets of shirts and pants that we should last for a
while. If I could also just add to what Legislative Yockey said, they did say it would last for quite a while, and it includes both summer, winter, all year round, the tire. So I looked at that list that Legislative Yockey requested, and I was kind of surprised by the quantity of things that they would get for that in my mind. So I think it's good.
Good. Okay. All
in favor? Aye. Item number 6H, approval and resolution for creation of a technical rescue team to support local fire departments and communities in Putnam County.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
That's perfectly right. Thank you, Emergency Services, for doing all the work on this grant. I know it's going to benefit the town of Cold Spring and the efforts that they have done to save people from Breakneck Bridge. This is going to help alleviate some of the issues that have been taking our local fire department up that mountain every week. But not only that, it's going to help the whole town. And
Item number 6I, approval of resolution to create an official hazardous material response team and fire investigation team. Currently, the county has had these two teams to support local fire departments and the communities in Putnam County. They've been very effective and very useful service to the departments in Putnam County. This is to officially establish it in the county code for these two teams.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you for the question. Moving on to the personnel committee, which I chair, on behalf of myself, Ms. Alana and Healthy, I'm going to move forward the approval of the fund transfer for attorneys for DM services. This is for services related for our home legislative council was appointed, and that is $777. Okay. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Item 6A is approval of local law to amend section 2.04 of the Putnam County Charter entitled Powers and Duties by adding a new subsection pertaining to the collective bargaining, labor disputes, and reorganizing existing subsections. If I may read into the record those changes, in section 1 is changed to point as being necessary and proper by resolution duly adopted outside council on a per case basis. Section 2 reflect the change of moving subsection R and renumbering it to subsection R to S and read as follows. R to appoint or consent to be appointed by resolution duly adopted a mediator or arbitrator in any collective bargaining, labor dispute, or negotiation involving the county as an employer. And S is publication requirements. Notice hearing shall be held by the county executive for the adoption of local law as provided for in subsection 3.04b of the charter and shall contain an abstract of the provisions thereof and shall include the location and availability and copy of the actual text in each local law. Any discussion? All favor?
Aye.
Now to audit and call upon legislator Cascarelli.
Thank you, Chairman Nasserino. On behalf of the legislators Bianchi and Sullivan, I'd like to bring forward the following. Item number 6L is the approval of the budgetary amendment for the planning department, ADA Transit Accessibility 2 Project Grant Award. Some grant money to make our transportation department a little more user-friendly to people that need ADA compliance and help. We're going to move $100,000 to cover the costs. It's $500,000 in total. $400,000 is in the grant money.
Any discussion?
Yes.
All in favor?
Aye.
Abstain. One abstention, no abstention.
refund taxes for Roberta Perry, dash map, town of Kent also, tax map 11.13-1-37, this is also a refund of a current amount of $4,204.56.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye. Abstain.
Thank you, Chairwoman.
Next, with all the business, I'd like to make a motion to the second ratio for the business segment.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
This is for the approval of the sales tax adjustment. This is necessary for us to pass in order to authorize this to go to Albany. We're making some changes and this will be a change that was implemented that pursuant to the authority of Section 1210 tax law, in addition to the sales tax and compensating each taxes imposed by Sections 2 and 4 of this resolution, whereas hereby imposed, there shall be paid an additional 1% rate of such sales, compensating each taxes for the periods beginning September 1st, 27, and ending November 30th, 2023. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Moving on to recognition of the public, if any Essex contribution chair, I'm sorry, we need second on that resolution. Any member of the public that wishes to come forward to speak, please come forward to state your name, your town, and the item you are referring to.
Still no false start, right?
Absolutely not.
Okay. Thank you. Good evening, legislators. I'd like to say that tonight I'm speaking Justice Lynn Eckhart from the town of Southeast now, not as a councilwoman. I wanted to I have a letter for you to the record on 6C about the proposed sewer district in the town of Southeast. I want to thank Legislative Booth for her vote tonight. I would also like to say on this project that I had a productive, spirited talk with Legislator Donkey, who I gave a conditional apology to, which he deserves, and I've never questioned, it's not questioning his work. He had spoken to our supervisor, but I was unaware of that, so I have an apology for that. Okay. Board of Legislators. As you know, I attend most of your committee meetings, and I was especially interested in your committee vote to authorize $160,000 to study two special sewer districts that the county would like to create. I'll address only the sewer district proposed for the town of Southeast, as I was shocked by how little research you've put into the current proposal. In fact, it's amazing that the legislature is willing to allocate $75,000 of taxpayer funding to a project they know so little about. For those of you who don't know about the proposal, it entails piping sewage on Route 6 from the village of Brewster to the Danbury, Connecticut plant. The first surprise is that all of these taxpayers are financially on the hook for the Route 6 East $75,000 engineering and legal expenditures. For example, when special district studies were done in the town of Southeast, only those property owners within a district are financially responsible for any funds expended, as they are the direct beneficiaries. Obviously, not so in this case. Taxpayers throughout Putnam County should understand that their tax dollars are being spent on the sewer district studying both Carmel and Southeast, with $10,000 allocated to Kent, and nothing spent in the remaining towns. The second surprise was that both the legislator and the task force appointed by County Executive O'Dell seemed unaware of the $102 million upgrades mandated to the current Danbury sewer plant. While $52 million of this upgrade will be paid for with federal funds, the remaining $50 million will have to be paid for by sewer users, which would include the 40 properties in the Southeast District. Obviously, it's apparent to do a simple math on this pending increase of $475,000 into this study. The third most important part of the project is the simple question, are sewers necessary? Are sewers actually needed to develop this quarter? Are your tax dollars being wisely spent? one has only to look at the State Line Retail Center to find the answer. The State Line Center was approved over 6 years ago in Southeast. It is a commercial, State Line is a 185,000 square foot commercial shopping center that already has approved septic fields. Yet to this day, State Line remains in Bucolic Field as no business is interested in building brick and mortar retail. Of course, this does not come as a surprise to anyone who reads about store closings and post-store earnings on a weekly basis. Finally, why would we bother with a comprehensive plan update in Southeast when our elected county officials believe they know best and should eventually dictate our land use? And why, until recently, did they exclude any elected Southeast County official from serving on this task force? While $160,000 in sewer engineering studies may seem like a drop in the bucket to some, it is never proven to waste money. Further, $100,000 here and $100,000 there really add up. Witness the recent $125,000 taxpayer funded settlement used to bail out the sheriff. In closing, it is mystifying that all Hudson residents are funding a project that will benefit only 40 properties, and it is unconscionable that your elected representatives are willing to rubber stamp and will concede an under-researched project that is likely too expensive to be built. Thank you. Can I give you a
FYI. That being said, I have a motion to adjourn.